Hey guys, welcome to a brand new episode of Planet Bollywood. मैं हूँ सागरिका छेत्री and I bring you the latest from the world of Bollywood, social media and entertainment. So without further ado, let's quickly have a look at the top stories of the day.
सुशांत के गुजरने से पहले एक हफ्ते तक रिया को एक भी फोन कॉल नहीं आया था. After Rhea left Sushant's home on June 8th, the late actor, who she has referred to as her boyfriend, didn't try to speak to her even once, even on the day of his demise.
Amidst growing drama surrounding Sushant Singh Rajput's case and now with the CBI taking over the investigation, many new startling details are emerging which were somehow in the dark so far. With hidden camera interviews and stings with Sushant's former staff members and with sensational revelations of Sushant's finances and call records, everything seems to be emerging in the public domain together.
Reportedly, Sushant's alleged girlfriend Rhea Chakraborty has blocked his phone number on June 8th. The call records also suggest that there was no conversation between Sushant and Rhea from June 8th and 14th, the day Sushant hanged himself in his residence. Interestingly, it was the time when Sushant was under extreme pressure post the demise of his former manager, Disha Salian. Times Now, which has been broadcasting a series of shocking stories related to Sushant's demise, have now revealed that they have access to the late actor's phone records. In phone records ke mutabik, Sushant seems to have cut off all communication with Rhea in the week leading up to his demise. Not a single call or message was exchanged between them, though Rhea in a post 1 month after his demise referred to herself as his girlfriend. Sochne wali baat ye hai ki 8 June ki raat ko Sushant ki ex-manager Disha Salian ka dehant hua tha, जब वो अपनी अपार्टमेंट बिल्डिंग के 14th फ्लोर से गिरी. 8 तारीख के बाद सुशांत और रिया के बीच भी बातचीत बंद हो गई. सुशांत फादर मिस्टर के सिंह रिसेंटली फाइल्ड एन एफआईआर इन पटना एंड कम्प्लीटली चेंज द डायरेक्शन ऑफ द केस बाय नेमिंग रिया एज द मेन अक्यूज्ड एंड अलेजिंग दैट शी मिसयूज्ड सुशांत बैंक अकाउंट्स, डिस्टेंस्ड हिम फ्रॉम हिज फैमिली and made him take incorrect medication that affected his health irreversibly. We now know that Sushant's family had concerns about Rhea and her family and the influence they were having on Sushant from February this year. Times Now had shared screenshots of the chat conversations between Sushant's family members and Sushant's brother-in-law, Mr. O.P. Singh's message to the Bandra East DCP, Mr. Dahiya, where he asks him to look into their concerns informally. Mr. O.P. Singh had also messaged Sushant warning him that he was in wrong company and also informed him that the DCP is aware of all the facts. After Rhea left Sushant's home on June 8th, his sister had stayed with him for a few days to counsel him. Lekin shayad kismat ko kuch aur hi manzoor tha. It is uncertain now why Sushant and Rhea stopped all communication just days before the actor's demise. Whether it was because of a regular quarrel between the couple or a breakup, or was it a more serious reason that will come to light during the investigations, only time will tell. But it is unfortunate to see just how lonely the actor must have been in the days and hours leading to his demise. After much suspense and requests of postponement, Rhea Chakraborty has finally appeared before the Enforcement Directorate.
Rhea Chakraborty, who is in the eye of storm surrounding Sushant's demise, has been facing multiple setbacks of late. Rhea, whose plea is pending in the Supreme Court for the transfer of the case from Patna to Mumbai, had requested the ED to postpone her questioning till Supreme Court announces its order on her plea. But that request too was rejected.
Riya was accompanied by her brother Shaovik, who is also under the ED scanner. Riya has been accused by Sushant's family of misappropriating rupees 15 crore from the late actor's accounts. Sushant's father has alleged that there was 17 crore in his son's account in 2019, jisme se 15 crore aise aise accounts mein transfer hue hain which are not linked to him. Earlier in the day, there was quite a bit of drama with Riya's lawyer Satish Mane Shinde asking for a last-minute postponement of her hearing. But the Enforcement Directorate, which is taking a tough stand on the case, denied Riya's request and stated that her absence will be registered as a non-compliance of summons. In addition to these criminal investigations related to Sushant's demise, Riya and her brother were also under the scanner of the ED after they discovered that she had managed to buy very expensive properties in Mumbai and had allegedly set up companies with her brother which have a very small paid-up capital and no employees. The ED suspects that these companies may have been fronts or shell companies to run a money laundering scam. Riya had also faced a setback in the Supreme Court recently when the court ruled that she could be questioned by the Bihar police who were then investigating the case. However, now she will be investigated by the CBI who have named her in the FIR they have filed in the case. Interestingly, Bihar's DJP Gupteshwar Pandey ne allegedly ek news channel se kaha tha ki Riya ED ke samne aane se inkar karengi, क्योंकि उन्हें अरेस्ट होने का डर है. मिस्टर पांडे इज ऑल्सो रिपोर्टेड टू हैव सेड दैट बिहार पुलिस की नजरों में रिया शुरुआत से सस्पेक्ट थी एंड नाउ दैट द सीबीआई हैज बिगन एन इंक्वायरी उन्हें कॉन्फिडेंस है कि सच सामने आके रहेगा. आखिर क्या सच है और क्या झूठ, ये शायद अब सीबीआई ही बता पाएगी, क्योंकि वक्त के साथ सुलझने की जगह ये केस और उलझता और संगीन होता जा रहा है.
I had to prove a point to my family. Most importantly, I had to prove a point to myself.
Kangna ki Bollywood ke khilaf jang jari hai. Sharing an old video of Sushant Singh Rajput talking about his struggle period, Kangna has accused the movie mafia of portraying the actor in a poor light and asked Sushant's fans to speak up before it's too late. Kangna, who has ironically attacked almost an equal number of Bollywood insiders and outsiders and pretty much anyone who does not agree with her, has shared yet another video via her social media team calling out those she believes wrong Sushant.
After Sushant's father filed an FIR in Patna, leveling multiple charges on Riya Chakraborty and her family, the investigation into Sushant Singh Rajput's demise is now following the money trail leading to Riya and her family. In spite of Sushant's family publicly distancing themselves from Kangna's movie mafia and nepotism narrative, Kangna continues to rant on social media against her B-Town colleagues.
इन द लेटेस्ट पोस्ट कंगना की टीम ने सुशांत का एक पुराना वीडियो शेयर किया है जहां सुशांत एक पब्लिक फोरम में अपने करियर के शुरुआती दिनों के बारे में बात कर रहे हैं, जहां वो 6 और लोगों के साथ एक घर में रहते थे. लेकिन ही वाज डिटरमिन्ड टू नॉट बी द डिजास्टर दैट स्टूडेंट्स इन इंजीनियरिंग कॉलेजेस गेट वॉर्न्ड अबाउट व्हेन दे ड्रीम ऑफ बिकमिंग स्टार्स.
दिस टाइम देयर वाज वन डिफरेंस, आई वाज ड्रिवन, माय सेल्फ रिस्पेक्ट वाज एट स्टेक. My ex-college mates, one of them is sitting right here in lecture, they thought that I was that disaster that folks in engineering and B schools should never become.
Kangna's team captioned the post, Sushant in his own words, how he dreaded being the disaster everyone thought he was. Unfortunately, even after being a huge success story, movie mafia not only projected him as a disaster, his worst fears came true. Kangna Ranaut. While Sushant's fans and other online trolls have already been attacking and trolling many Bollywood celebrities, especially those who come from film families, Kangna ne ek aur social media post mein Sushant ke fans ko appeal ki hai that they should speak up before it's too late. Please speak up or it will be too late. A gold digger girl who was with SSR for just few months will become the scapegoat, and people who systematically broke his mind and willpower will roam free. It looks like Kangna and Sushant's family are now following two different narratives of what they believe drove the actor to his tragic demise. Sach kya hai? Ye to waqt aur hopefully kanoon hi bata payega. आलिया और जानवी पे फिर साधा निशाना ट्रोल्स ने। As both the young actors get ready for their films to have an OTT premiere, they have had to deal with a fresh wave of anger, hatred and accusations of being privileged insiders, जिन्हें अपने स्टार स्टेटस की वजह से बड़ी फिल्मों में काम करने का मौका मिलता है।
सड़क 2 एंड गुंजन सक्सेना बायोपिक आर द टू फिल्म्स व्हिच आर स्केड्यूल्ड टू हैव एन ऑनलाइन प्रीमियर दिस मंथ। But it looks like the star cast excitement has been massively affected by the online trolls jinhone film ke lead stars Alia Bhatt aur Janhvi Kapoor ke khilaf awaaz uthai hai. Jaise hi film Gunjan Saxena biopic ka trailer release hua, Janhvi Kapoor and the film received a huge backlash from the netizens. Similarly, when Alia Bhatt shared a poster of the film Sadak 2 to announce the release date of the film, she received a lot of backlash from the netizens who are also upset with the fact that Alia Bhatt ne apne social media account pe apna comment section turn off kar diya hai.
In the aftermath of Sushant Singh Rajput's demise, the insider-outsider debate and accusations of nepotism have resulted in many star kids like Alia, Sonam, Janhvi and Sonakshi and producers like Karan Johar receiving thousands of hateful comments and threats. Janhvi ki film Gunjan Saxena, The Kargil Girl, which is scheduled to be released on August 12th on an OTT platform, was the first to battle the hatred with trolls, giving the trailer 80,000 dislikes soon after it was shared on a video sharing app. Such was the intensity of the trolling that Angad Bedi, who plays Janhvi's brother in the film, had to speak up and say that the film also has Pankaj Tripathi and him who do not belong to the film fraternity or family and have worked very hard on the project. Speaking to a news publication about their film and the anger it is facing from a section of the audience, Janhvi said, "I've gotten chances that many people wouldn't have gotten easily. So from now, if the journey is a little bit of an uphill climb." Pankaj ji, jinhone khud ek lambe struggle ke baad kamyabi pai hai, added, "Right now, it's as if the book is being judged by its cover. Aur logo ko is film ke baare mein ek galat rai nahi banani chahiye." Janhvi ke saath saath Alia, who has been facing the brunt of public anger after she shared another poster of her upcoming film Sadak 2 and announced the release date of the film on an OTT platform, logon ne Alia ko rude comments aur memes se target kiya hai. Not just for the poster release, but for also keeping her comment section disabled even after making a big announcement. It's ironical to target one or two insiders when so many outsiders who have struggled to get an opportunity are being unnecessarily affected by the backlash against the films. Ummeed yahi hai ki log ek insaan ko na dekhkar 100 se zyada logo ki mehnat ko dekhe jinki wajah se ye film ban pati hai.
After they failed to appear before the National Council of Women on the 6th of August, the NCW has issued fresh notices to Urvashi Rautela, Mahesh Bhatt, Isha Gupta, Moni Roy and Prince Narula, summoning them to record their witness statements against a Sunny Verma who has been accused to sexually assaulting and blackmailing women after promising them modeling assignments through his company IMG Ventures.
Sunny Verma and his company have been accused of heinous crimes by social activist and People Against Rapes in India founder Ms. Yogita Bhayana. Ms. Yogita has alleged that Sunny Verma had a systematic modus operandi to trap young girls with modeling aspirations and then blackmail them, causing them tremendous emotional and psychological trauma.
The celebrities have been summoned since they allegedly promoted Sunny's company. Expressing their displeasure on the absence of these celebrities, the NCW has warned all those who had been summoned a failure to appear on the next date would result in strict action being taken as per the procedures of the organizations. However, Isha Gupta, who is one of the celebrities named by the NCW for not attending the meeting after being summoned, has shared a series of social media posts declaring that she had received no communication and that her name is unnecessarily being maligned. Isha wrote in one of her many posts, "Respected ma'am, Sharma Rekha, as a woman, I would stand by any woman who has been wronged. But if no information has reached to us, then why is my name being dragged here? I am ready to cooperate and not ashamed, hence making it public here." At Smriti Irani. Isha also tagged politician Smriti Irani in another post and wrote, "Respected ma'am, please help me clear this ordeal. This isn't the way to try and use our name." According to Ms. Yogita Bhayana, many popular celebrities have unofficially removed any videos or material that could have linked them to Sunny Verma, calling them two-faced. Ms. Bhayana said ki jahan ek taraf ko Sunny se koi connection nahi rakhna chahte, wahi wo hearing mein aake is baat ko manzoor nahi karna chahte that they did know him or were in contact with him in the past. Speaking about how Sunny carried out these grave crimes, Ms. Bhayana says, through his company, he, Sunny Verma, invites the girls on the pretext of organizing a Miss Asia contest with a claim that the contest will launch them as models. To make it look genuine, his company has also been taking an entry fee of 2,950 rupees. लेकिन अप्लाई करने के बाद सनी अपने फीमेल अकम्प्लिसेस के थ्रू इन्हीं लड़कियों पे दबाव डालते थे कि वो कॉन्टेस्ट में चांसेस इम्प्रूव करने के लिए अपने अश्लील फोटो सबमिट करें। फिर इन्हीं अश्लील फोटोज का इस्तेमाल करके सनी इन लड़कियों को ब्लैकमेल करते थे और उनका शारीरिक शोषण भी करते थे। मिस भयाना एड्स दैट शी हैज लेटर्स, टेक्स्ट्स एंड ऑडियो क्लिप्स फ्रॉम सेवरल वुमेन to establish a pattern in his modus operandi and prove the wrongdoings of him and his company. After the Me Too movement took the industry by storm almost 2 years ago, this case proves how the filming and modeling world still has many predators who take advantage of vulnerable young girls and leave them scarred for life. We hope ki celebrities jinke paas badlav lane ki taakat hai wo NCW ki help karke Sunny ke victims ko insaaf dilaye.
Har roz naye khulase ho rahe hain Sushant Singh Rajput ke case mein. We bring you the top 5 updates in the case. First update: CBI files its FIR and takes the first step to investigating Sushant's demise. After receiving the nod from central government, the Central Bureau of Investigation has lodged an FIR against Riya Chakraborty, Samuel Miranda and others involved in the case. What had initially seemed like an open and shut case of a troubled celebrity's demise is now becoming murky and a sinister mystery, with unanswered questions emerging every day to only create more doubts and suspicions. The CBI has now taken over the case and filed an FIR naming 6 people in it. But still, meanwhile, questions like torn diary pages of Sushant and missing keys and friends who know a little about Sushant continue to shroud the case in intrigue. Second update: Siddharth Pithani talks about the mystery of the missing key. Kyun darwaza toda nahi gaya? आखिर डुप्लीकेट चाबी कहां गुम हो गई? क्यों 2 घंटे चाबी बनाने वाले का इंतजार किया? These are the many questions being posed to Sushant's associate and flatmate Siddharth Pithani, who was allegedly amongst the first persons to discover Sushant after his demise.
Ma'am, the only reason we sent the listing was Sushant wanted over a private man. He wanted his privacy.
Siddharth has said in his defense,
that in spite of their best efforts, they were not able to break the door or find the duplicate key, because of which a key maker had to be called. The key maker was sent away by Siddharth and Dipesh, who also lived in the apartment, after he opened the door to allegedly protect Sushant's privacy. Lekin unfortunately, by then it was too late and the actor was no more. Third update. There are now reports that evidence tampering may have occurred in the Sushant Singh Rajput case, after Times Now reported that it had learned that crucial pages from Sushant's personal diary were allegedly ripped off. When were they ripped off and by whom is still under investigation. Fourth update. Times Now has asked Siddharth Pathani about the missing pages from the diary and whether he knew anything about them. Siddharth has denied tearing the pages and also claims that contrary to Sushant's sister's statements, he did not find any torn pages in the room. Siddharth has also added that he didn't know what Sushant wrote in his diaries and it was personal, but that a whole stack of diaries was taken away by the Mumbai police.
No, ma'am, I did not see any torn pages, but there were books, books with torn pages inside them also. There was a stack of books which we have submitted.
Fifth update. Producer Ramesh Taurani has shared that he had given Sushant a film narration call before his demise. Mr. Taurani has, however, said that he couldn't be sure about the actor's state of mind since he had only spoken on the phone. He added that the shooting for the film was to start at the end of the year and that the late actor didn't speak to him about any other matter during their call. New developments and drama continue to deepen the mystery around the case, and we will keep giving you all the updates as we get them.
Planet Bollywood mein lete hain ek chota sa break, but stay tuned because I'll be back in a short while.
Deepika, Ananya aur Siddharth shayad jald chalenge Sri Lanka as we finally get some good news about the Shakun Batra directed film, which was delayed by the pandemic. Fans of all three actors have been excited to see these three very different stars together on screen, and with a maverick director like Shakun at the helm, it is sure to be an interesting project.
After a seemingly endless wait, we hear that Deepika Padukone, Ananya Pandey and Siddharth Chaturvedi may finally be on a film set very soon. The three who share screen space together in Shakun Batra's next project may be back in business come November when the team aims to resume shooting in Sri Lanka. Keeping our fingers crossed for the entire team.
As per news reports, Shakun has decided to create an exclusive team of only 50 people who will fly to Sri Lanka and begin shoot for this much delayed project that is untitled as of now. While it was initially aiming for a Valentine's Day release next year, lagta hai ab iski release date bhi kai baki filmon ki tarah push ho jayegi. While not much is known about the story or characters, we hear that ye ek relationship drama hai jahan characters morally ambiguous situations mein phas jate hain. Speaking about this exciting new project, Deepika had said in an interview earlier, "To be honest, you can't call Shakun's film light either. Although the overall tonality of the film is slightly lighter than my last film, in terms of inner emotional turmoil my character goes through, it's quite challenging. The overall genre of film is something we haven't seen much in Indian cinema. It's called domestic noir." Ananya, who has shared her excitement about working with Shakun, Siddharth and Deepika, had also commented, "I told him that I'd do anything he directs. I'm just going to sit there like a student and try to absorb as much as I can." Here's hoping ki ab aur koi obstacle na aaye and this exciting group of artists can finally get down to work and share some details about this rather intriguing subject and film.
Well, that's all for today. Do not forget to leave your views and comments in the comment section below on our social media handle and digital platform. And also go check out the Zoom Facebook page for more updates on Bollywood. This is me, Sagarika Chhetri, signing off for now. You guys have a great weekend, but stay home, stay safe, guys. Bye-bye.